Hi guys, welcome to my next tutorial. At the beginning, I would like to thank you for all your donations so far. I was able to make this beautiful doily. I hope this time you will want to help me again by donating to my channel to give me opportunity to create another tutorials and also help me in developing my channel. Now I would like to tell something more about this doily. So for this tutorial, I will use crochet hook 1.75 mm, and as you can see, 10 different colors of crochet thread yarn Rico Essential for crochet hook 1.75 mm. You can also use any crochet thread yarn number 10. This doily is measured about 32 inches, so it's a 32 inches long and about 13 inches wide. So if you would like to make it in a different size, you have to change the crochet hook size. Also, if we don't need to work with the different colors, you can keep continue my instructions with only one color. That all depends what you want to make. Our work, we need to start by making slip knot, then chain of 20. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, and 20. Now we need to work slip stitch into the first chain to make ring. Now we will start round number 1. Chain of 3, 1, 2 and 3. This is the first double crochet, and now into the ring we will work 39 double crochets. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10, and then we need to keep continue until we will have 39 double crochets plus chain 3, so 40 stitches. I've done my 39 double crochets and chain 3 space, so I've got 40 stitches. So at the end we will work slip stitch into the third chain, so 1, 2 and 3. We need to join into that chain, but now I will change the color. So instead of making slip stitch by using the first color, I will grab my second color of the yarn and I will make slip stitch by using the second stitch. Now I will pull my yarn through and I will cut the orange yarn, orange thread, and now I will make small knot to secure my ends. And now we can start. As we've joined with the second color, we will work chain of 3 as a first double crochet. And now in each stitch, so into the next 39 double crochets from the previous round, we will work one double crochet. I will try to hide the ends of the yarn during my second row. So I've done first double crochet into the second stitch, then into the next one, double crochet, and into the next, double crochet, and in each stitch all the way around. So at the end again, you should have chain 3 and 39 double crochets. And again, I've got my 40 stitches, and I need to work slip stitch into the third stitch, but now I will grab another color and I will make a slip stitch by using the new one. Chain of 3 as the first double crochet, and exactly the same as on the previous, I will cut the yarn and I will make small knot to secure the ends. And now, after, as we've done chain of 3 as a first double crochet, we need to work one more chain stitch as a chain 1 space. In this round, round number 3, we need to work one double crochet in each stitch. So we are going to the second stitch now, and then chain of 1. Into the next double crochet, then chain 1. Into the next double crochet, then chain of 1. So at the end of this round, you should have 40 double crochets, because chain 3 is a count as a first one, and 40 chain 1 spaces. After each double crochet, we need to make chain of 1. Okay, so now we've got round number 4, so I swap the color to the white one already, and we need to start by making chain of 3 as a first double crochet, then chain 1 as a chain 1 space. Now we are going into the second double crochet and chain 1. So basically this round we need to work exactly the same as we've done the previous round, 40 double crochets and 40 chain 1 spaces. Now we've got round number 5. So again, I've changed the color already, and now we will start by making chain of 3 as a first double crochet, then chain of 2 as a chain 2 space. Into the next double crochet we need to make double crochet, then chain of 2. And again, into the next double crochet, 1 double crochet, then chain of 2. So now we need to repeat this pattern all the way around. So at the end we will have 40 double crochets and 40 chain 2 spaces. Round number 6. So after, as I make slip stitch with the next color, now we need to make chain of 3 as a double crochet, then chain of 3 as a chain 3 space. Then double crochet into the next double crochet. Chain of 3 again. Double crochet into the next double crochet. Chain of 3 again. So now we need to repeat this pattern again all the way around, and then we need to repeat making one double crochet and chain 3 on the next round as well. So this is round number 6, so then we need to change yarn for the next color and make again double crochet and chain of 3 in round number 7. I finished my last 2 rounds, round 6 and 7. So now we need to start round number 8. So again, I change the color, so as I am making in each round, now chain of 3 as the first double crochet, then chain of 4. As a chain for space. So we start by making 7 chain stitches and now double crochet into the next double crochet. Chain of 4 again. 1, 2, 3 and 4. Then double crochet into the next double crochet. Chain of 4. 1, 2, 3 and 4. So now we need to repeat this pattern all the way around, and after this round, round number 9, we need to work exactly in the same way. So double crochet in each double crochet and then chain of 4. And now we've got round number 10. Chain of 3 as a first double crochet, then chain of 3 as a chain 3 space, now single crochet into the chain space. Chain of 3 again, double crochet into the next double crochet. Chain of 3, 1, 2, 3. Single crochet into the next chain space, then chain of 3, double crochet into the double crochet. So now we need to repeat this pattern all the way around. At the moment this is the last one round and then we will start working in rows. So we need to keep continue to the end of this round and then I will show you what we need to do next. So chain of 3, single crochet into the chain space, then chain of 3, double crochet into the double crochet. And now, as I said, we need to start working with rows. At the moment we will start with the longest part of our doily and we need to start by making chain of 3 as a first double crochet, then one more double crochet into the same stitch as we've done slip stitch and first chain of 3. So we start by making 2 double crochets. Chain of 3, 1, 2 and 3. Now we need to turn our work and into the second double crochet or into the top of chain 3, we need to make 1 double crochet. So second row got 2 double crochets as well. Now row number 3, we need to start by making chain of 3, then we need to turn our work into the same stitch, we will work 1 more double crochet. And then into the top of chain 3, 1 double crochet. So row number 3 got 3 double crochets. Now row number 4, chain of 3, then we need to turn our work into the next 2 stitches, 1 double crochet. So row number 1 and 2 had 2 double crochets and row number 3 and 4 got 3 double crochets. Row number 5, chain of 3, then we need to turn our work 1 double crochet into the same stitch, then 1 double crochet into the next 2 stitches. So row number 5 got 4 double crochets and then into the top of chain 3. Row number 6, the same. Chain of 3, then 1 double crochet into the next 3 stitches. Row number 6, 4 double crochets. I miss one. So 1, 2, 3 and into the top of double crochet 4. The next two rows, 7 and 8, we need to work the same. So into the row number 7, we need to add one more double crochet into the first stitch. So chain of 3, then 1 double crochet. Then 1 double crochet into the next 3 stitches. So row number 7, we've got 5 double crochets. Then row number 8 will have 5 double crochets as well. Chain of 3 and then 1 double crochet into the next 4 stitches. 1, 2, 3 and 4. So now we've got 2, 4, 6, 8 rows. Row number 9, again, chain of 3, double crochet into the same stitch. So into the first one we will work 2 double crochets, then into the next 4 stitches 1 double crochet, 1, 2, 3 and into the top of chain 3, four. Then row number 10, chain of 3 and 1 double crochet in each stitch, so exactly the same number of stitches. So basically now we need to keep continue our pattern. So in each odd rows we need to add one more double crochet than on the previous row. So now we need to start row number 11 and we will add one more double crochet to have 6 double crochets in our row. To have 7. We should have 6 double crochets in row number 10. So row number 11 and 12 need to have 7, row 13 and 14 8, 15 and 16 9, and then each two rows have to make one more double crochet until we will have 34 rows in total. So at the end, on the 34 row, we should have 18 double crochets. So exactly the same. Each two rows, we need to work with one double crochet more than the two previous ones. We need to add one more double crochet in each odd row. Now I am at the end of my 34th row. As I said, I've got 18 double crochets in my last two rows. Now we can fasten off and cut the yarn. So first part at the moment we've got done. And now we need to grab another color. So make sure that your work is straight and we are going into the next double crochet on the right side. So we need to join into the double crochet. So again, I will make a little knot It doesn't matter which side actually you've got, if it's wrong or right. I am joining into the wrong one. And now again, we need to start with 2 double crochets, so chain of 3 and second double crochet into the same stitch. Chain of 3, 1, 2, 3, we need to turn our work 1 double crochet into top of chain 3. Row number 3, we will have 3 double crochets, exactly the same as on the first part, so double crochet, turn your work again, 1 more double crochet into the first stitch, then double crochet into the top of chain 3. And now next thing what we need to do, after the third row, we will work chain of 2 and we will join chain of 2 and we need to join into the third row on our first part. So 1, 2, 3. Into the top of double crochet, or actually chain 3 space, we need to join. So we need to work slip stitch. And then we need to turn our work, slip stitch into the chain stitches. So 1 and 2. Now slip stitch into the double crochet and we will start row number 4. Chain of 3, 1, 2, 3. Then 1 double crochet into the next 2 stitches. 1 and 2. Row number 5. 1, 2, 3. And again, we need to add extra double crochet. So double crochet into the same stitch. Then 1 double crochet into the next 2 stitches. So 1 double crochet and then into the top of chain 3. So in row number 5 we've got 4 stitches and now we need to repeat. Chain of 2, 1 and 2. Then we need to join into the 5th row in the first part. So slip stitch, then we need to turn our work, slip stitch into the chain stitches, so 1 and 2 and then into the double crochet. Now chain of 3, 1, 2, 3, 1 double crochet into the next 3 stitches. So this is row number 6 and we've got 4 double crochets. Row number 7, 1, 2, 3, chain of 3. Then again we need to add 1 more double crochet and then 1 double crochet into the next 3 stitches. 1, 2, 3 and 3. Chain of 2, then slip stitch into the 7th row from the first part. And then we need to turn our work, slip stitch into chain stitches. 1 two, then into the double crochet. Chain of three, one, two, three, one double crochet into the next four stitches. So basically number of double crochets we've got exactly the same as on the first part. So our pattern we need to repeat one more time. Only one difference is after each odd row we have to work chain of two, then slip stitch into the same row on the first part. So we have to join it, and then we are going back and we need to keep continue our pattern. So now again we need to repeat what we've done on the first part in each second row. So in each odd row we need to join to the first part, and now we need to work 31 rows, so three less than on the first part. So we should finish with the 17 double crochets. This is actually first row with the 17 double crochets, and then I will show you how we need to make another part. So 31 rows, at the end 17 double crochets. In each odd row we need to add one more double crochet, and we need to join to the same row on the first part. Okay, now I am at the end of my second part. I've done 31 rows, I've got 17 double crochets. This is actually the first row. I've done the last chain of two, and I joined to the into the same row on the first part. Then I go back, made slip stitch into the two chain stitches, then into the double crochet, and now we can fasten off and cut the yarn. Now we need to go back and start next part. So we need to turn our work, so shorter part is on the right side, and again we need to join into the next double crochet. So now I will grab another color. And basically we need to work exactly the same as at the beginning. So we need to join into that double crochet, and we need to work on our pattern. So now I will show you the first three rows, and the rest you will work by yourself. So we need to start by making chain of three, then double crochet into the same stitch, into the same double crochet, then chain of three. We need to turn our work, one double crochet into the top of chain of three, then row number three, chain of three, and again we need to turn our work, one more double crochet into the same stitch, then one double crochet into the top of chain three. And exactly the same as we've done on the second part, now we need to join. So chain of two, make sure that your work is not twist, and we need to join into the third row from the second part. So everything is going exactly the same. Slip stitch into the two chain stitches, one and two, then into the double crochet, chain of three, one double crochet in each stitch, and from now we need to repeat our pattern. So now we've got row five, and now we've got row four, and then we need to start row number 5. So we need to keep continuing exactly the same. In row number 5 we will have 4 double crochets, and we need to join into the 5th row from the first part. Now we need to keep continue our pattern until we will have 28 rows, and at the end we should have 15 stitches. So again, 3 rows less than on the second part. I am at the end of my third part. I told you to make 28 rows, but please work one more row, so 29, and you should have 16 double crochets and then chain of 2 and slip stitch into the same row on the second part. So we need to work 29 rows, so 2 less than on the previous part. Now again, we need to go into the next double crochet on our right side, and we will start working exactly the same. So we need to join, then chain of 3 as a first double crochet, 1 double crochet into the same stitch, chain of 3, we need to turn our work, 1 double crochet into the top of chain 3. So basically again, pattern staying exactly the same. Chain of 3, turn your work, then 1 more double crochet into the same stitch. So into the first stitch we've done 2 double crochets, and then 1 double crochet into chain 3. So row number 3 with 3 double crochets, then chain of 2, and we need to join into the third row of our third part. Then slip stitch into 2 chain stitches, one and two, slip stitch into the double crochet, chain of 3, 1, 2, 3, 1 double crochet into the next stitch and into the top of chain of 3. So now again, next row chain of 3, double crochet into the same stitch, then 1 double crochet into the next 2 stitches, chain of 2 and slip stitch into the next, the same row on the third part. So now we need to keep continue our pattern, and we need to work 2 less rows than on our third part. So we need to make 27 rows, and at the end we should have 15 double crochets. I just finished my fourth part, so now we've got 27 rows, and we will start next one. So I've joined my next color into the next double crochet on the right side, and we need to start exactly the same as each part. So chain of 3 as a first double crochet, then 1 double crochet, chain of 3, 1 more double crochet into the chain space, into the top of chain 3, then chain of 3, 1 double crochet into the same stitch as chain 3, and then 1 double crochet into the top of chain 3. Now we need to work chain of 2 and slip stitch into the third chain of our previous part. Now slip stitch into the 2 chain stitches, 1 and 2, slip stitch into the first double crochet, now chain of 3, 1 double crochet into the next 2 stitches. So basically, as I said, each part we have to start exactly the same, only one different is with the number of rows. So at the moment we got 27 rows in the last part, and now we need to work 2 less, so we will work 25 rows on the 5th part. So at the end, in 25th row, we need to have 14 double crochets. Okay, so I finished my 5th part, and now we will start part number 6. I will not show you each part how to start and how to make all rows, because you know it already. So at this part we need to again work 2 less rows as we've done on the previous part. So we had 3, 5, 7, 9, 11, 13, 15, 17, 19, 25. So in this one we need to work 23 rows, and at the end we should have, so in the last row we should have 13 double crochets. And then we will join with the next color into the next double crochet, and we will work next part. So now 23 rows, and at the end 13 double crochets. As you can see, I've done my 10 parts already. So each one is 2 rows shorter than the previous one, apart from the first ones. So at the end, on the 10th part, we've got 13 rows. And as you saw on the picture already, now I will start from the green one again, and I will continue with those colors for the next 10 parts, for the next 10 double crochets. So now we still need to repeat our pattern. So again, we need to start with 2 double crochets, but only one different is we need to make each another part only 1 row less. So now the next one part will have 12 rows, then 11, 10, 9, until we will have 20 parts in total. So from now we need to join in the next color, and then keep continue our pattern until we will have 12 rows. So now, as you can see, I've done my 20 parts already. So my last part got 5 rows. So each part we will work in with 1 row less than the previous. At the end we should have 5 rows. And then after the last small part, we need to join with the same color as we started at the beginning, and we have to start working everything all again. So another 20 parts on the second part, so for the next 20 double crochets we need to work exactly the same. And then on the picture you can see how the whole work looks like, because it's quite big and I am not able to show you exactly how it looks like now. So thank you for staying with me to the end of this tutorial, and don't forget to subscribe to my channel. See you next time!